out there. I know I've not been here on this channel for a while now, with school stuff and such. And this video just kind of wanted to talk about like my situation and stuff that's going on. And now at times like I felt better than before, and now, how I said before, I am on antidepressant pills that I take like every morning, like once a day. I don't know exactly what I want to talk about, I just kind of want to talk. Or like... at times not really being sure how I feel. Or... I know it might be repetitive, the things that I've said before and what I'm saying now, and I'm just a bit rambling. But I just kind of want to talk about how I feel and just kind of be honest. I'm just like sitting in my pajamas and still need to wash my hair that it's been a week, I haven't washed. And just kind of want to talk about like sometimes I still don't feel all that great, but at times I don't know if it's what I'm feeling is still classified as depression, but I am in a much better mood than how I remember how I used to feel. When kind of like I talked about the video, like when it was the cycle and everything before that happened, things like that. But at times I'm kind of still in a mood that where I don't really want to do much, and maybe not as hard as myself, but. I don't know, maybe I can still, I don't know if you would consider it self-abusive, I don't know, is that a word? Maybe just haven't figured myself out yet. Also, since me being a senior, kind of know the... Yeah, we're in November now, are we? Yeah, we're in November now. Like, all the college application things and people expecting me to kind of know what I want to do, what I want to study, and things like that. And I do have passions and hobbies. Like, I'm always scared a lot about animals. Also about cats. I don't know if I've said this before here on this on YouTube, but I did have a cat named Casper that I had before I moved to this new house, before I moved, I changed house this summer. But after we moved, like in this house, there's no like a no pet policy, so meaning no animals can be inside the house. And also Casper, my cat, like once we moved here, like he didn't really stay outside this house, so I haven't really seen him since, but he's always been like kind of a wild cat, so I don't think he's dead, I just think he decided to move somewhere else because maybe just got upset that he couldn't live inside the house anymore. Because of the previous house, he wasn't allowed inside the house before how, because of how he behaved, like a few times in the middle of the white couch, and my mom was not okay with that, so that's why he's not allowed in the house anymore. So maybe because of that, I don't know why exactly, I don't have his mind. He didn't want to live in his, like with us in his house anymore, so I think that he might have decided to live somewhere else. But like we did kind of missing papers and like put around the neighborhood, but like we still have not found him. So I think he just decided to live somewhere else. I don't believe him to have died because he's used to being by himself and all of this. So anyways, I just kind of missed him, even though before like didn't visit them all the time, but at least once a day usually saw him, like to give food or just pet him. He was still kind of a bit wild here and there, but I still loved him and still do love him. But there's also like kind of that thought from my cat not really being with me. And also just like the school work is not that hard because I'm not in AB anymore. Still a magnet school, but it's just not what is really hard for me right now. It's mostly like, I don't know, preparing for the future or my life or where I'm supposed to go after, because I don't really know. And many times I feel like people kind of expect me to know, but I still don't really know. Like my love for animals that I've always had and this passion for animals. But I think also like science, like when I took biology in 9th grade, I liked the class, and also in the UC I got a 5, which I was a bit shocked because I'm not usually the best at testing. But I also like biology, but I know it's complex, and from 9th grade to now I've done basically no biology. And also like nature and just being self-expressive, like just express myself and help others. So I don't really know what I want to do. And I know many colleagues say it's okay, you will find yourself there, and you have like, what's it called, like 1 year when you can go like not declining your major. But the thing is, I don't even know which school I want to go to, and things like that. So I find it stressful. I think probably so many other students find it stressful. But maybe just also this idea of college is supposed to know where I want to go, and many other students already know where they, not many, but there is a few like they want to go to these schools and this, or maybe that major, and I still haven't really figured all of that out. And many times I feel like I'm supposed to have already known, but I don't. So many times I just kind of feel lost and kind of worried where I'm going to be in the future and all of this. If I'm going to stay at home or like in a college dorm room, and kind of all these thoughts. And at times also like, I don't know, maybe it's also because I've not been sleeping enough, and at times I'm a bit distractive, or like maybe it's also like due to Netflix at times, like I'm really into some TV shows or things like that, so it keeps me occupied when I should be doing other things or working. Or maybe I use Netflix as well as kind of a distraction from my own life, and instead of dealing with my own problems, I just kind of push them aside, push them away, not really wanting to think about it. But also like watching at times, I don't know, but also that has to do with watching different YouTube videos, just keep watching YouTube videos at times when it's a bit redundant and too much, so I don't have to do other things or things about, think about things that worry me or may not be, make me feel so good. Sort of that happens at times. This video is a bit all over the place, but it's just me talking and rambling. I don't know, I just kind of want to make an update on how I've been doing. And also like, what was it? Yeah, on Friday, I always forget, like, if it's called psychiatrist or something else, like the doctor. Yeah, I think it's psychiatrist, the doctor like who gives you like medicine for depression and all of those things. So I've been to my, like, yeah, I think therapist is the, like, yeah. Sorry, I was just thinking about all these things. So I went to my psychiatrist and to get more of my antidepressants and such. But like at times she asked me questions like, oh, are you still depressed? Are you feeling better? at times, like I didn't even know what to reply. Like I've been taking the antidepressants for a long time now. Like I started even before summer and stuff. So by the time, I don't know if they even make a difference. I'm used to taking them, but at times I feel like I still have symptoms of depression, but not as much as I used to before. So I don't know where I stand. So I don't know. And also like anxiety, I don't have any, what is called, like diagnosis for it, but it's still there. Like my like anxiety and depression for me, like kind of a bit go hand in hand together, I feel like. But I feel, but if you're like, are you depressed like directly? I don't really know exactly what to say. Like, I don't know why you're asking me. Like, I feel like if she talked to my therapist, she would understand better. Like, she would give her a better answer, because even though I feel different things, I don't know if it that, or like I would have to spend a long time and talking to her about everything. But also my mom was in the room, and then that day I was just tired, like not really even want, like even in the mood to be there, and because of course like doctors think you always have to wait some mostly a long time to go in, and for all of stuff I was just very tired that day and was not in the mood to talk that much, and like her just kind of, I'm not saying she's a bad person, like anything bad, it's just I was not really in the mood. I know she was just doing her job, but at times I feel like they're just kind of like, are you feel like this? Like, so are you feeling better? Are you not feeling better? Like, how I'm just supposed to know this information? But many times I feel like I don't even know, are you the doctor? Are you supposed to know and tell me how I feel? Or things like that? Or like, I feel like you wait there for a long time and then you spend like in their office like 5 minutes, and then like they send you off with the prescription and for the prescription, and that's it. Like, I don't know, I don't want to like judge all the work and their experience in the college things. Maybe it's just from my point of view, and just feel it's a bit not rude, but just very quick. And not that they don't pay attention to you, but like, is it blunt? I don't know. But like, how you're kind of already supposed to know what you're feeling, what you're going through. At the times I'm just confused, or like, I don't know if it's symptoms or like my illness, if you can say, like how I'm feeling, like kind of relating to depression, anxiety, or if it's just kind of a school thing at times, or maybe it's because I'm on my period, things like that. Or me not knowing about the future, things like that. Is that connected to depression? Or me just very much questioning things and being unsure. And then at times she would ask my mom, like, how do you see her? Things like that. But the thing is, like, when I don't feel that great, or many times I don't do it on... depends. At times I kind of do it on purpose. Or like, when I don't feel that great, or like, feel vulnerable, like usually like in a bad mood or things like that. When I feel a lot, I don't usually show my parents what I'm going through, at least not most of it, or like try to keep the more intense part of myself. So her kind of asking those questions, if I might be going through a tough time, which at times I might. Like, she doesn't get the full, like, my mom would not know everything, or like, only she sees only kind of what I let her see at times, which doesn't always describe how I'm feeling completely. So, kind of, these are kind of the things that have been going on inside my mind, if they make even any sense. I'm just at times just trying to figure myself out, which I don't really know. I still go usually to therapy once a week of sending our videos therapy. They say it's 1 hour, even though it's 45 minutes, and the other 15 minutes, the therapist like is there taking notes and like kind of making account of what the session has been like and things like that. And also like I think you're supposed to like schedule like every therapy session like by like you cannot schedule like in a straight time like 3:26. It always has to be hour by hour, so you were 3, 4, 5, things like that. And I'm probably just rambling in this video. I'm just kind of feel confused about future and how I'm feeling, so that's why I'm just rambling. I don't know if anybody even wants to listen to all of this. I don't know, just a 17-year-old senior girl who deals with stuff. Sometimes I don't know if I even know myself, like understand what I'm feeling, or like why I think in a certain way, or like what is going on in my mind. And many times I just kind of feel so tired, not in the mood to do stuff. And I know that's probably a side of depression, and at times even if I might be in school and sit with a bunch of people that I know, they kind of, but they may maybe not really be talking to me, so I kind of feel alone, and kind of those thoughts of loneliness and a bit of not being worthy, and worthiness at times do come up, but then other times I still do laugh and have a good time, even though like recently or just talking to friends or like making also making with phone calls, never really like doing that. I just kind of feel tense, and I don't know, I'm not used to hearing like other than my grandmothers and like family of that kind, like friends like on the phone, like hearing their voice just feels weird to me. I'm just more used to texting and other things or seeing them in person. So even just schedule things over the weekend to see people, haven't seen people like over the weekend with friends in a bit in a long while. So I kind of miss that, but that was also like being alone and just doing my own thing. But like I think my parents at times kind of worry about me about that, because many times like my mom is a bit forceful, just really like, oh, are you going to like invite this person to your house or that, or like she wants me to be more connected and around people, and I get what she's doing and I know she has good intention, but at times that I don't know, kind of that push, like that forceful push, like her kind of wanting me to do this and that, can be a bit bothering, or like at times when I just kind of want to have more like the freedom of deciding what I want to do and things, like her at times telling me what I need to do and this and that, and at times bothers me. And then like the more she says something, the more like I have the urge to not say something, to not do something. I don't know if that has anything to do with my depression or anxiety, or it's just been a part of being a teenager. But I feel at times I feel like I just want to have my own freedom or fix that. Like my parents are like, are you washing your hair? Are you washing your hair? Like all this morning, like I finished my homework and things. It's Sunday, now it's a bit like late at night. Like you've been forcing me, not forcing, but like telling me, like kind of wanting me to wash my hair and everything in the morning. But the more the state say, the more like I feel like I don't have a choice, I'm just supposed to do what they want me to do, and the more it makes me feel like I don't want to do it, so I still haven't done it. Like kind of having that freedom of being able to do my own thing that I like, or just really kind of being able to breathe, but the more they force something on me, the more I feel like I don't want to do it. I don't know if that's a good thing. I feel like it can be problematic for me now or in the future. I don't know, this is just kind of what has been going with me, been going on with me and my life. Like My grades for the most part like are all good. Actually, what was it? Yeah. On Friday, like I was in the honor roll. Yeah, honor roll, like meaning mostly A's and B's here and there. Like I had all A's and a B, but the thing is, like the B bothered me because it was in Italian. So, like in my mind, it might be in a messed up kind of way, like. My perfectionist unperfect my perfectionist imperfect self. I think like it should have been done better. Why did you get a B in Italian and all those things? So at times me and my ruminating thoughts a bit hard to deal with at times, but still like I know I should be happy and all of that. But even though I'm, for the most part I am doing good in school, I don't know. Maybe with everything else that's going on, I still have a hard time to deal with. And like I did my homework in my brother's room because like the desk was less of a mess, and I even cleaned up that desk because it bothered me. But my room, my desk in my room is still kind of all a mess. But I didn't want to look at it, so I came in my brother's room, that is where I'm filming this, which is a new angle, just sitting on the bed. So yeah, I don't know if this even is a video that makes any sense, but this is what I've filmed so far. I hope if someone has stayed here till the end, whoever stayed here until the end, that you've enjoyed what I've said so far. Hopefully we'll make more videos with, no, not with, but that make more sense than this one. A bit of a ramble everywhere, this one, and hope you enjoyed this video. If you have anything to say to me, or like any comments or things that relate to this video in any way, or something that you think might help me, or just kind of want to talk to me or anything like that, you can leave a comment down below in the video. If you like me talking and rambling, you can like the video if you want to, and keep on watching for whenever I make any other video, which I don't know yet when that will be, but when it will be, you will see and find out if you subscribe, if you want to. Okay, bye, see you another time.